Hello, welcome back to Go and Walkabout. Today I continue with the iOS app. I start a new project, and that is creating a new post editor in Swift UI. A while back I already told you that I want to slowly improve the app by adding new features in Swift UI. And today I start working on a new post editor in iOS 14 in Swift UI. So users on iOS 14 will eventually get the new post editor. Other users will remain and stay on the current one. Now, the reason why I want to create this new post editor is that I also want to have the ability to create historical posts. So maybe you want to enter a historical trip, but more importantly, say you've been out in the field the whole day and you get back in your hotel and you want to create a story of the day. Now, you do that actually later than it actually happens. So you want to be able to maybe modify the date, or use the date from your photo, or use the location from your photo so that, you know, in the evening, in your hotel, you can still replicate the trip you had that day. And that's what I'm going to build in Swift UI for iOS 14. So let me show you what I'm doing so you can follow along. Now, it's all new for me, so I make mistakes. You will see them. Let me know so I can improve. But this is my story, how I get accustomed to Swift UI and how I update my app. Now, the first thing is doing a demo. What you can see is we have a trip here. If I trip plus, we get the new post editor. And the first thing you notice is this, the post editor puts the maps front and center. I like maps, and that's also what I want to do in this new post editor. And what I've done so far is I have show a map with the user location in the center. I print that here, and I print here the reverse geolocation of that particular location. And I can click on this, and it will show me a list with nearby places. Now, if you look at the existing one, so producing this list is existing functionality. Also, getting the location, the current location, is existing functionality. But I have reused that and put it here to work in Swift UI. This is only the first part, because the next one will also be adding photos and using the photo picker, as I showed you in the previous episode, to build up the images. And then I also want to use the date and the location of the images for this particular post. But let's first see what I've been doing so far. So the first thing I had to do is here, when I add the trip, I need to check if I have iOS 14, then I create my view model for the trip post edit. I create the UI hosting controller with the view that passing on the view model here, VM, and I pass a dismiss action. And this is one thing that is important and took me a while, but I am in my UIKit application. I pop up my Swift UI, I write some stories, and of course I save it to the data store, but then I still need to trigger an event to rebuild this application, because maybe the map changed, or maybe you are here already in the list view and it needed to get refreshed. So I need to make my traditional UIKit application aware that something changed in my Swift UI part of the application. And that's what I do here with this dismiss action. So I pass on the dismiss action, and this will get called after I dismiss my Swift UI view. Now, and then, of course, after I've configured it, I present it, and it will nicely show up, as you just saw. And for users that are on a lower iOS, they'll just get the traditional way of doing it. So the only tweak I made here, if iOS 14, go to the new editor, and else, stay on the old editor and everything the way it was. Now, let's go into the editor, because we had the view model that I created. And that is what encapsulates all the business logic. And in that, I created some published variables for the current location, the region, and the place. So I have the location, longitude, and latitude. I need to have the region to print the map. And I need to have the place, which is actually the reverse location of the coordinates, so that I can print that in a nicely form. I need a flag to make sure that I show that nearby picker or not. And I need my location manager. Now, of course, this location manager I reuse from the existing part. This is my location manager, and when I create this view model, I initiate it. But it needs a delegate, and I use self, so I make my view model also the delegate for my location manager. And I know I could rewrite this using Combine and doing it all a lot nicer, but I didn't want to rewrite my location manager at this point yet. I want to reuse what I have so I can make the step to a new user interface, a new editor in small steps at the same time. Not rewriting everything every time, all the time. This is just a more reliable way of doing it. Now, when I have that delegate, I need to implement my delegate functions, that's updated location. So when the location is retrieving the coordinates, I print that here, I get my current location, then I set that, I recalculate the region to show on the map, and I do the reverse geolocation. And that will then trigger, if that has found it, the update place, and it will update my place and set the current place to a value. So, and when I load it, I refresh the post edit. So when I, on appearance of the view, I call the refresh because I might have to do something later. Not at this point, but when I start using it for edit, right now I use it for creating new ones, then I need to retrieve, of course, the existing post. Now, as you see, this is all the business logic that I currently have around my location. Then I have, of course, let's put it here, an convenience initiator so I can use it in preview. I'll skip over the previews at the moment because I'm not really happy with how they work. But anyway, this is what I have done for that. I have some preview data here as well that I will not get into at the moment. Then we get to the view. And I use my view model as an absorbed object. And I have the dismiss action because those are the two things I passed in. But you could see here in the view controller, I pass in my view model and my dismiss action. And that is actually what we have here, the view model and the dismiss action. And this defaults to void, but it is set to close it the way it is. And I create my view. Now, my view of a navigation view inside the scroll view, I put a virtual stack. So that let's go to the post editor so we can see it side by side what I need. We have the VStack with the map. Here we have the map. And I set that to a height of 200. Show user location is true. I bind that to my current region. I print the text to the latitude and the longitude for here. And if we have a current location and if we have a current place that is not nil, then we show, this is a button with the, that if we click it, we set the nearby picker, we toggle it. It's false. This was in my model here, the Boolean to show that. And that we use the binding there to make sure we show it. We get to that in a minute. And we have the H tag where we show the nice symbol and the text here inside the button. And when this button is pressed, so the button has a sheet attached to it, if is presented, and then the view model show picker. Here we bind the value that we set here, we toggle it from false to true, etc. And we bind that and we do the sheet. And the sheet, if it's presented, will show my nearby picker, with a nearby picker view model, show it, because it needs to have that variable so it can also close it. So we show it from the parent, but inside the child, so in the nearby picker, we can cancel or save or select, and then we need to close it again. And we need to return the selected place. So what is selected? That's the nearby picker that we go into in a minute. On a pair of this view, we refresh the view, as I said, we have the navigation bar and the items, the cross and the save. Now we're here, now we press this, we get into this nearby picker. That's what happens here when we press the button, we toggle the show nearby picker, we show the sheet in the nearby picker view. And the nearby picker view is again a view model. Observable object, that's the pattern, every view a view model, keep it simple, and for me it's also much more understandable if I just keep doing it the same way everywhere. We have location and the set of selected places. We initiate with the location because, as you saw here, we will only print this button when we have a location. So we have determined the location, we show the button, and we pass that on to the picker. And that picker will then refresh and will use my place service, get nearby places for a particular location, returns that with the dispatch queue to make sure you do that on the main thread, and put it into the self places. when it is in my business logic, yeah, in my view model. Now in the view, we bind that, we set the view model, we show it, and we have the selected place with binding objects. We print it, we have a simple list, and on a pair we refresh. So in a pair we call the view model refresh, meaning we get the services. Then it will render it here as a list, the navigation bar, the loading items. Now, and inside the list we put a button, and we set the selected place to the place that is on that list row. And we call the show model toggle. Now, the way we do that is because we have these binding variables that we can use, and these bindings are passed in from the post editor. As you can see, we create the view model, the picker with the view model, the view model, we pass in the show model and the selected place, and we use the binding here to get that into the view model of the parent. So this view model is the view model of the trip post editor. And that's why if we select now one of these items, we select it, we click the button, we set the selected place, show model toggle. It's now open and visible. We click it, we hide it, and it gets here. And because it's a binding variable, this one gets updated. Now, this way, I have now my my post editor and my nearby places pickers in Swift UI. Both have a view model and a view. Very simple, as I said, keep it consistent. And I have hooked them up together by using the binding variables for showing and to passing back content. But once we press here to save or the close that I haven't implemented yet, or the close I have, we cannot do that because from this parent that you see, the normal trip, what is not a Swift UI application, I cannot pass in the binding variable. And that's why I use here, if I my dismiss action, so in the navigation bar item, let's pop it up again, this cross, my navigation bar item leading the dismiss action. And this dismiss action gets called because I pass that in, and that's how I can close the pop-up to continue working in the normal UIKit part of the application. And I can still get notified that something has been done. Now, of course, this is only very small part of the whole post editor. Next is adding images and getting dates of images and getting location of images and quite some things. Remember, I also worked on a weather API so I could retrieve the weather. So it's a pretty big project by itself, but this is part one. I hope you like it. If you like it, please like and subscribe so that you won't miss the next episode. If you didn't like it, you might like this next episode better, so subscribe anyway. I'll thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.